better one there.
It feels bigger.
Today I'm fishing with Chris Schmidt. He's invited me to try and catch one of his big bluegills that lives in his lake. He's got some lunkers. Some of them can reach as much as 2 pounds. So if all goes well today, there'll be a big one flopping on the ice before you know it. Most people have no idea that I'm a world-class bluegill angler.
You like walleye better than bluegill?
And if you're interested, today I'll be showing you some neat methods for cleaning and cooking these delicious fish. I'll also demonstrate the pumping foot luring method for big bluegills. It's rarely used in the Midwest, but highly effective. And there's big ones lurking below, so let's get after them.
But look at how fat that belly is on him. Oh, wow.
Now Chris feeds his fish with optimal fish food. It really grows them big, and you can buy your own from the Herman Brothers.
Look at that. That's a good one. That's not what's in here compared to what we're after, but that shows you, man, you get 10 of them in your bucket, you've got a beautiful mess of fish. What do you say, Chris?
That's a good one, buddy.
Way to go, boy. That's a good one.
It's all fun, but life throws you a curve now and again. And losing your best friend, well, that's pretty sad. 1 minute you're fishing, and the next minute, your heart is broke.
Come on, Jack. Jack. Here, Jack.
Well, the worst possible scenario, my dog went in the beaver hole. I was out here ice fishing, and Jack was over here sniffing around playing like he normally does, and he went in a hole. So, been digging for 2 hours, and you can see where we made a hole here. Trying to get Jack out.
Jack! Jack! Come on! Jack! Here! Jack!
So he's not answering me. And so now I call the backhoe. Trackhoe,
but you can see the nightmare. It's 25 feet up this hill, straight up and down, and a lake in front of us. So
I don't know how we're gonna get Jack out of here. Then we gotta dig Jack out without collapsing the dirt on top of Jack. So it sucks. I'm pretty scared.
It's gonna be dark by the time the trackhoe gets here, and they gotta bring a bulldozer so that when they hook the trackhoe onto it and bring the trackhoe downhill, it doesn't slide in the lake, and then the dozer holds the trackhoe back. So
My little dog's getting expensive, but you gotta do what you gotta do. He's your buddy, you gotta try to get him out. I heard him fighting something in there, either a raccoon or a beaver, and I haven't heard him since, so. See what happens.
That's why you gotta live life to its fullest and relish those moments when things are good. How would you like to have this view? It's what a fish sees right before he goes in the bucket. The fishing was really good. For one of us, that is.
I just hooked what I thought is maybe the biggest bluegill of my life. Chris says the way he's pulling it might be a bass, but I just got a look at him in the water, and holy cow, I have hooked a huge
largemouth bass.
Ah! Nice.
You can just see how beautiful this fish is, and look how wide he is. Wow. Caught him on ice hook. It's pretty amazing.
Good job.
All right, let's let this guy go and see if we can get one of those giant bluegills. Come on. Go do your thing there. Look who just came out of the hole.
Been a long time since you left me here. On the east side, feeling low. You had no time to waste another year, and I don't blame you. Things around here move too slow.
Jack! Here! Jack! He's a little sore from fighting. Would you fight, Jack? Yeah, you're in trouble. You know you're in trouble. You made Clint dig holes for 2 hours he's been digging. And I...
You know I've been yelling at you. He doesn't look too smashed up, does he?
He don't look too beat up. He must have won the battle.
Jack won, Beaver zero.
Images.
I could hardly keep my hook in the water.
You're biting now, brother.
Yep.
Chris, on the other hand, well, let's just say it must have been his technique. You see, he's doing it all wrong. The bluegill looks at his bait and, well, swims away. He's jigging too fast. Meanwhile, I have perfected the bouncing lure technique. And yep, they can't resist. Now, Chris was trying to be nice, but I could see that he was pretty jealous. Not because I was catching 10-to-1 fish, but it was my rod. You see, Chris's rod is short and kind of thin. Poor guy. Mine, on the other hand, is a hefty longer one. And definitely thicker. Good for me, but kind of sad for Chris.
All right, buddy. No problem, man. We're going to eat some fish, but I wanted to show you a little bit about one of my favorite ways to cook bluegills. This is a secret that Bo Jackson shared with me, and Bo and I are a lot alike in ways that we like to eat wild game, but he's a better cook than I am, so I take his advice most of the time, even though he won't listen to me when I give him good advice. But anyway, here is, these are bluegills, and if you look at them, you can see they look kind of odd. Well, Bo skins his bluegills a lot like you would a catfish, and since I've been doing that, oh my goodness, it's one of our favorite ways to cook them. And then the other way you can do a bluegill is just flame, and these are filleted with the ribs filleted out of them, so you get all that. But that's because those are big bluegills on Chris's lake. You can see how big they are. So then you want to take some buttermilk and roll them in cornmeal and fry them. And we're going to do that now. It's going to be good.
One indicator of a great bluegill ice fisherman is the release, the scoop. It takes a lot of finesse. The slam dunk, not too hard, just stand directly over the hole. The layup, pretty easy as well. Most folks can master that one right off. But the three-pointer, well, dang it, that happens. You gotta get warmed up. And it's not a high percentage shot for any angler. There we go, now I've got it. Hey man, even Jordan missed a few long shots.
Over the years, you probably noticed I do a lot of self-filming. It's not as practical in the kitchen because you only get to use one hand. But anyway, everything's good tonight. We got Jack back, and we're gonna have bluegills, fried bluegills. I mean, what more is... What more does life have to offer than wild game and living that outdoor lifestyle, getting your hunting dog back when you thought you might lose him. Pretty awesome night for me. I had my son home with me and getting ready to chow. So, all right, these fish are cooking. Let's give them a little bit till they turn golden brown and then cook them even a little bit longer. I like my bluegills to be cooked good all the way through. Cook the water out of them. We'll see how these turn out. Now, as I said, we took the catfish skinners and we skinned those bluegills just like you would a channel cat or a bullhead. Cut their heads off and gutted them, and now we're going to fry them like that. But you can also scale your fish with a spoon like most everyone does, or with a knife. But there's something about when you get that skin off like this and you fry them with the bone in, that bone releases some kind of flavor that is just darn amazing. So a lot of you, if you've never ate a bluegill with the bones in, when we get these done, I'll show you how to clean them after you cook them so you don't get bones in the meat when you're trying to pick through them and eat them.
So what do you got, Chris?
Got a pretty good bluegill here.
This is what we've been waiting for. Oh baby, look at that. Wow. So Chris is a pretty good sized guy, got fairly big hands. Look at this fish here. And he says this isn't a big one. That's about a 3/4 pounder. Oh look, he's only got one eye. That's why he bit your hook there, Chris.
Yep, that's the only reason I caught him, right?
So Chris invited me over because my passion for giant bluegills is about the only thing I really fish for, and he said he had them, so quite a giant, but it's a big one. And it's a beautiful day for fishing. It's just now if we can sink our hook into one of them 1.5-pound bluegill.
It'll happen.
Yeah, that's a nice one. Way to go, buddy. So I'm back to the old boot tapping method. It works pretty good. They actually swim right up and jump out of the ice hole. Not a big one though. It happens when you least expect it. I've hooked a giant. Dang it, but he snapped me off and it was my favorite jig. After losing a lure, a fresh fried bluegill will make anyone feel better, that's for sure.
Clint's already home barking orders because he's the chef of the house. He's making some kind of concoction here for celery. What is it, Clint?
I'm going to try to pickle some celery.
Ooh, that sounds
good. My first go at it. We'll see.
Maybe we can pickle some bluegill fillets.
I don't know how that works. All right, I put some rosemary in here. I don't know what rosemary really is, but we're going to see.
And vinegar.
And vinegar. I got apple cider vinegar. I was looking for white wine vinegar. But...
Okay, the bluegills are ready to take out and eat. So here we go. We're going to get them out.
Watch how things can turn from bad to fantastic. Must be another one of your big bass.
Maybe that's that 11-inch gill.
Whoa, Big Johnny! Look! That's what you're talking about right there. I lost my good tungsten hook and I just caught this bass. And look on the side of his gill. Look at that. What's the chances of that? Huh? There you go. Thank you.
All right. Well, we have got the bluegill out and it's ready to be eaten. Now I want to show you, if you cook your bluegills like this, whether you scale them and eat them with the skin on, fried, or if you decide to try, you know, skinning them like a catfish and frying your bluegills, and you've ever done it before, then I'll just show you a quick way that all of us that eat them that way know how to do it. And I'll show you real quick. But you want to hold the camera on this bluegill. All right, so you take your bluegill once he comes out of the hot oil, you know, and pull that back fin right out of there. All right, because that's got those sharp bones on there, and you don't want them in there, obviously. You hold him by his tail, and you pull this bottom fin out too, and you get that one there. Man, I can tell that's going to be amazing. Then you grab the fish right here in the middle, like between where the ribs are, and just gradually pull that apart. If you want to use a knife, it can help it, like when this fish is hot. And you just move it down through here like this. Look at that. Is that a beautiful piece of work of art or what? Man. All right, just I like that meat on the ribs there. That, oh man, that is just heaven. So you take a big old bluegill like this. This bluegill was pushing, you know, over a half a pound. He was a good sized bluegill. And skin him and cook him whole. Roll him in a little bit of buttermilk and roll him in your favorite cornmeal mix. And if you don't have a favorite cornmeal mix, just get you some Andes or regular cornmeal and add some salt and pepper. There you go. Mm. I might even eat Clint's fish.
Man, it looks like I'm gonna have to step up my game if I'm gonna beat Chris now. He's caught a half-blind bluegill that's pretty big. And I can see by his reaction he's feeling pretty good about himself. As the day wore on, my arms began to get tired from catching so many fish. But I still hadn't caught Big Louie. Suddenly, I had one that felt pretty big. Nope, it was just a fish stick. Dang it. In and out. Hey guys, if you're here hoping to watch the spear hunting, be sure to subscribe to my channel. I've loaded new ones and will be loading more soon. If you subscribe, they'll pop up where you can see them. And if you like the spear hunting, go to slockmaster.com. There you can buy spears, blowguns, and a bunch more. Days later, I've slocked Big Louie. Chris is on the board again.
Big male.
They're fat too. Turn his head towards me. Yeah, they're fat.
That's tall fish.
Well, we're catching fish. And there's nothing like big bluegills through the ice, cold water. Flay those guys up, or you can scale them and eat them whole. That's my favorite way, but today's the day. The bite is on, and I think the fish are liking the sunshine as much as we are, Chris. I just hooked another one, and it looks like a good one. Look at that, boys. Look at that. What a beautiful fish. Woo!
Good job. So Chris invited me over to catch one of his big bluegills, and we caught several, but nothing like this one. Look at that. Wow. Yes, sir.
It's a good one.
Isn't he pretty?
Yep, beautiful colors.
So that's neat when you catch a big bluegill. You gotta, you know, most people like to catch bass and walleyes and stuff like that, but I got what I came for. I got a big one. Now I'm gonna try to get another one.
Remember in life that quitters never go home with the biggest bluegill. That's why I stuck it out till the bell. All right.
Hot chocolate.
So we're all relieved here. Our hunting dog is our best buddy. And I'm gonna get the conner bears out and take care of them beavers. Beavers, you know what? Beavers have been the problem in my life my whole life. Another beaver problem here. All right, let's go.